And welcome back. We're now into for our second match of this best of three in the loser bracket semi-final between Vega Squadron and My Insanity. The first match was a little bit of a fast one. Vega got a Lash Wreck Shadow Demon and it just actually just ran all over them. An early mech onto their Shadow Fiend and they just kept on going. My Insanity had no answer for that with their little bit unusual draft. And we'll see how they do it now in the second game here. Zach is with me again. How are you doing? Still doing great?
It's still going great. Game one was absolute shambles. That's an English phrase, by the way. It just went totally wrong for My Insanity. Picking that old traditional draft, didn't do it much for them.
No, not at all. And now they said they just got Lash Wreck, now we get Lash Wreck.
Yep, that's how it works right now. And I'm really loving the Queen of Pain ban. I've been casting a lot of Queen of Pain recently. I hate the hero. I really do. So OP.
Yeah, the pure damage, especially going through to BKB, is just so annoying. And being a lane dominator on top of that, just like the Viper here, it's just so tough to deal with.
Yeah, Viper's really understandable right now because Clockwork's main damage early game is just magic damage, and Viper with the corrosive skin doesn't care. And they know that Mag is one of the best European Clockworks right now. So Viper, really good pick there.
It also just gives them a solid mid lane for which they can work on.
Yeah, really Viper bullies the lane. That Never Toxin always makes sure that Viper dominates the CS as well.
Indeed. We'll see if they're actually going to respond with another Shadow Fiend for mid here. But it's a fine. Yeah, they're not able to do so. My Senti, they banned it. They're trying to ban out heroes from last game, but they just didn't like.
Yeah. What I'm also loving is the Rubick pick here actually works out really well for Vega because Rubick can only steal Viper Strike, which is Viper's ultimate. And yeah, Rubick's going to have a really fun game. Yeah, Rubick has some really good spells to steal so far, like Leshrat. No spell off Leshrat's bad at all.
Well, Pulse Nova, I want to say, is actually not good because you have to get close, and being a Rubick, you don't want to get close.
Yeah, that's also a good call.
That's maybe a little bit of a problem, but yeah. Apart from that, you always have a free ultimate to steal. From the Viper, so.
Look at it, go! Here we go with the Witch Doctor.
Oh my god. We're gonna see some Gask Bowsing and some Death Wards going on.
And me screaming. I love casting Witch Doctor. I reckon he's my favorite hero to cast. Especially when he gets the Illusion Rune. Witch Doctor am I?
You just love the lines that he says.
Yeah, Witch Doctor is the most banterous hero in the whole of Dota, in my opinion.
Yeah. I think it's in the bag from Skyrath Mage.
Oh, that one's long and drawn out, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
It definitely rubs it in their face, especially when you win.
Yeah. But if you lose, it's like, well, what's in the bag now?
Yeah.
And then you get another 10-minute answer.
Look, it's in the bag. Look at it. I can see it. It's in the bag.
I always forget all of those things. I'm really terrible at remembering all those lines and stuff.
Oh, I quote them all day. Oh, I say them to my mom every night before I go to bed. I live Dota. I breathe Dota. Dota's not a game. It's a passion. And for everyone who's watching it, agrees with me right now. And yeah, hopefully this is going to be as fun as the last game, but hopefully more drawn out and more even.
Yeah, not 2 minutes. Or what, 2 minutes? Not just 15 minutes. And like, okay, next lobby.
Yeah, not the quickest game I've ever casted in my life, but Phantom Lens. Ooh, PL. Radiant team pick. I've been casting a lot of PL. PL is, I don't want to say it, but I think PL's returning to his previous state, Cancer Lancer.
No. It's a different kind of hero. Like, the old PL was more late game oriented, and the PL now is more fighting combat oriented, a little bit more in the mid game. You have to be active to really get something out of the PL.
I think PL, if anything, it's just got better. Like, PL is now a better hero than he was before. Oh!
Finally! Meepo, he got it! Lizard, hell yeah! And like, we're gonna get it. I'm gonna send him a message right now. Finally.
Hey, you legend. You legend. Lizard Meepo. Let's go, boys.
Okay, we got it here. Finally.
No, the Gask is really good versus a Meepo and a Clockwork. Actually, Clockwork is not that good as well as a Rubick. They're actually quite susceptible to a Meepo. If Clockwork gets a Meepo, he usually gets 2 to 5 Meepos.
Yeah, and also, the Earthbind cancels channeled abilities, and there's usually 5 Meepos to stop the Witch Doctor from making it go. And then, Poof is also very good against Phantom Lancer illusions.
Indeed, he's really good at clearing them. And you can also keep everybody down, so all the illusions plus the UPL are stuck to a place when you just start throwing nets at them.
Yeah, I just can't wait for the Twitch chat to go absolutely mad when they see Meepos just come out.
Indeed,
from the side of my insanity.
I'm actually just reading it right now.
The green team's banning someone now.
So yeah, this is going to be fun. Really fun. And actually, Meepo has quite a good synergy with Lestrake. Just throw out the net. You get an easy spread earth.
Yeah.
It's just, man, I'm already loving this right now. And they ban out the Ember. Yeah, it's a great ban. Yeah, that's just a really understandable ban, actually. Like, yeah, it's a great ban versus a Meepo. If it gets Battle Fury's ups, all the Meepos standing together just get destroyed. Like, just that easy.
Yeah. I'm going to love casting this game. This game should be fun, and hopefully it goes quite late as well. Also, the Tusk has been banned out here. Do the Meepo clones, like, do they all count as one hero in the snowball?
I think they do.
Yeah, that'd be a really good combo.
Yeah, definitely. It would be funny to see, but yeah, but they banned it out, so no chance of that happening.
Yeah.
I think it does indeed get one by one.
Yeah, Meepo will riot. Everyone just writing Kappa.
A lot of Kappas right now. Meepo, hell yeah, Meepo. You guys know it.
Oh, shit, a Meepo. And, I'm...
yeah,
I don't know what... just, what... Okay, what are Vega looking to pick up now? I think it's a mid-hero, right?
Yeah, essentially versus Meepo, you're looking at either... Storm Spirit. Well, solo... Yeah, this is one of the things that could indeed work. You're either looking at something that can burst down a Meepo or destroy all of the Meepos at the same time. So either AoE damage, a lot of it, or a lot of burst damage. So you can just burst one up and be done with it.
Yeah.
And Storm Spirit, they're going to go for the single target idea here. Although they don't have that much of burst damage. And Storm Spirit can get blown up by Meepo.
Who do you think wins mid, Viper or Storm?
Really, man. Is that even a question? It's Viper.
Like, Storm has the overload as well. Like, that could also help.
Yeah, but come on. If Viper wins the lane from Storm, he has a little bit more range. His Toxic is really hard to deal with, and getting poison on your face all the time is not that fun either.
Yeah, but this is G, and G, very good for VP as well. See what happens.
I'm going to be taking the Radiant right now again because we have Lizard on his Meepo. I've never had the chance to cast that, so I'm going to look forward to see what he does with it. We have Milan on the Lashwreck. We have Gogi on the Viper. We have Cuisine on the Dazzle. And last but not least, we have Mitch on the offlane Spearbreaker.
And on the side of Vega, we have Seema rocking that Witch Doctor. Look at it go. We have Solo playing the Rubick with some lovely cosmetics there. And on the Storm Spirit mid, we have G rocking that Orchid hat. And now we have Mag once again playing a very good Clockwork around. And then finally, we have PL with the scary eyes, played by Pasha.
Where are you moving with your camera? I thought I was following your camera, but you're looking at all the other places.
I'm looking at the scoreboard right now.
I was following your camera on the map to see which hero you were going to be introducing. But every time I move it there, you were just looking at different heroes that you're saying. So I'm like, what?
That's magic. The using the scoreboard is easier for me, so...
Well, we're going to see it now. Are they going to get a first blood again?
GG.
Oh, that's fast. Nice.
They're just trolling, I guess.
No, I think that's a mistake. But yeah, this is just a mistake type there. But we're gonna see it through the fingers for now. We'll just let it continue. And it's actually gonna be Milan in the middle with the Leshwreck and Gogi here. Viper on the safe lane. Okay.
Didn't see this one coming.
And this is actually, yeah. As Clockwork, he can't really be on this lane now. That's a little bit troublesome. And they actually sent in solo to help out G, because they thought there would be a Viper here. Oh, lift up onto Milan. Do they have anything to keep him down after that? No, they don't.
Ooh, there's going to be the charge.
Yeah, it's only level 1, so it doesn't do that much. He is being slowed. Yeah, this is not going to... It's 340 versus 290, like... He's going to be able to run away from this.
Oh, G's a bit far up here. Mitch is coming in. Just going to give him a few punches in the face.
Currently, they're just dual laning on mid. Mitch pulled up, back, and Milan. He just walked forward now. They want to go into solo. They're actually diving underneath the tier 1 here. And they're able to get it with a split earth here. There you go. G takes some damage, but they will leave him for now.
Very well played. Nice communication there. And Viper is doing okay on the bot lane against the solo mag. Mag's going to have a lot... Like, he's going to have a very difficult time against his tri lane.
Yeah, he's not getting the easy way out right now. Not one versus one. Mag is taking some damage here from the wolves now.
Yeah, he's trying to prevent the pull.
Yeah.
And he has. He's successfully done it as well.
Lizard should be... Is he going to stack right now? Okay, he just got the aggro for no reason. I thought he might be stacking for himself later on, so he can just pick it up real fast once he has 2 or 3 meepos.
Yeah, that's a good point. Have they got? Yeah, they've got some heroes that can take the stacks. Like Leshrac can easily take a stack.
It's true.
It's true.
They got enough. Yeah, it's fine. They got a lot of heroes.
Cool, Lamau.
Only one thing now, BL is being absolutely let alone here on top. Parsha is just farming it away.
Yeah.
Like, Mitch is like, nah, man, screw laning, I just want to gank. And he's going to go after G right now. There we go, he gets pushed back even further on the tower. Split Earth does hit, but Milan, however, gets lift up, thrown to the tower range. And he's taking quite a lot of damage, he only has 200 HP now. He probably uses Bolder now a little bit. Yeah, he'll get back up there. So far it's just really weird laning stage with
Lizard going hand bottom,
but they just have one meepo, so only one net and Mac. Yeah, he's fine.
Yeah, just punch him in the face. What's this little shovel he's got? Is it a shovel? No, it's a little mace that Meepo's got. Oh, and I love the pipe as well. Meepo having a cheeky spliff.
It's an old one. Okay, successful earthbinds. Okay. Yeah, yes, I said there's a lot of inscribed things on it as well. Okay, look at his back piece. Successful earth bites. Almost just over 24k. You can see that he played a lot of Meepo.
Oh my god. Jesus. 24,380 earth bites on Meepo.
Oh,
and he has level 3.
And they actually found Gene right now in middle with Mitch here. Him being there all the time finally paid off. They got another kill. Well, paid off for the second time now.
Yeah, Lizard's just owning this jungle right now, pulling creeps left and right.
And now Mac can't actually contest this anymore because he gets 2 meepos in his face and that will just deal too much damage for him to really deal with. As well as Battery Assault will be divided among all of them.
I think this is a position for Meepo, right?
Yes, it's a position for Meepo, that's what he usually plays. But you will see fairly soon, once he gets a little bit of farm, a little bit of levels, he will just snowball and he will be able to fulfill core position usually. So we'll see how it goes. He does need to get some farm priority then, or jungle priority. Oh, they get a sentry out. They see Mech. Are they gonna earthbite him? Yes, they will. They're gonna get a kill on him as well with the shadow wave there at Meepo. I'm gonna drop you down. There we go. And at the same time in middle, G takes another fall here. With the dual lane mid here, pretty much getting a third kill already.
4-0 on the side of my insanity. It's a lot different from the first game. yeah, they're looking very strong so far. And, well, the only big massive benefit right now is PL is in total free farm heaven.
Yeah, he has 39 less hits already. He's now up to 40. And yeah,
I think he's missed one.
Might not be. Then yeah, actually, yeah, he has missed zero less hits at the moment.
Yeah.
And yeah, he even got that one. So far, he's keeping up his perfect last hitting score.
Hmm.
It's really nice. Pretty good as well. Oh, Lizard, he is seeing Mech. Is he gonna throw another of him? Yes, he will. There's gonna be the second Meepo coming in right now. Better resolve is popped. Canceling the poof there. But yeah, the second Urbind is there as well. And they're just gonna kill him off here with the Viper. This is, yeah, this is because it's a lot of at this lane for Mech.
Yeah.
It's just no comparison to last match where it was just versus a solo. Oh no. Lan. He's gonna try go for him. He's taking a lot of damage here, but Mitch is coming in trying to help him out right now. He might just be left there for dead. Milan get out another lightning here. Mitch is still fighting up. He's fairly tanky. And oh, Cousine is now also there. Milan gets pulled back in, but he had Shadow. Oop.
Ooh, Shadow Grave. Oh, yeah. Milan's is going deep now.
Yeah, Seema. Oh, no. Seema's still alive. The Gask. Oh my god.
Ooh,
two zap. For two. Two supports are left. Who is gonna win this one? Cousine is on the hunt. The Dazzle Man. He's mad.
Yeah.
But solo, he's just a bit faster.
Yeah.
Oh.
Bah. Solo's fine. Solo's got this.
You know, we've taken a lot of damage here.
Yeah, PL just pushing out the top lane.
Yeah, this should be a fairly easy tower. They're sending it in Spear Breaking now, but the level is he? He's level 4? Yeah, level 4. That's not high enough to deal with it. You can just pretty much just bash him a couple of times or try to, and then he has to look away. There you go, first spirit lance.
He hasn't dropped the last hit. I just kept my eye on him, he hasn't dropped one yet.
Ooh, harsh, yeah.
Oh, now in trouble.
Yeah, this is a little bit overzealous there, but Rosine is already there with the Shallow Grave on time. Benedict is not doing enough damage here.
And Pasha gets the last hit on the top tower.
And they get, actually, they get the courier here. Milan got it on his way over.
Yeah, we have a 7-minute mech on Viper.
That's
wow.
That's what you
Mask
get for getting
madness?
This.
PL? What? Well,
then you, that's actually odd, I want to say. Like, you're actually versus a pretty burst-heavy lineup, so if you have it on you, you're actually going to take a lot of damage. It does help you, though, with farming and all those kind of things, but... Yeah, if you want lifesteal to farm, you usually get a Vladimir's.
Yeah, Vladimir's, and it also affects your illusions, right? But I think the Mask of Madness affects them too, if I'm
not it
wrong.
Gives them lifesteal. But...
Yeah.
Now you also have already filled up your unique attack modifier.
Huh. Yeah, Diffusal Blade isn't one anymore, so I don't think that's his main problem.
No, it's not his main problem, but it's always good to keep an eye out.
Yeah, he's just flash farming with the Mask of Bandits, I think.
Yeah, that's the idea. Leave the lane to the support, so and then he uses his Mask of Madness to farm the jungle.
I think we should give Meepo a bit of love right now. Meepo, he's got 26 last hits from pretty much pure jungling right now. He's been pulling the creeps. He's given Mag absolutely nothing to work with. Yeah, Lizard's playing outstandingly so far.
Yeah, this is the... At the moment, he's actually already ahead of Mitch and last hits. Leshbreck just got another kill here. Jeez, however, still able to get out. They only get the Seema the Slayer on the Witch Doctor.
Yeah, just to remind everybody, Vega are 1-0 up, and they are currently behind at 9 minutes. The kill score 8-2 to my Insanity.
Yeah, we're gonna just take a quick look at the net worth right now. The top farmer is Pasha. He just got so many less hits already. It's crazy. But after that, we have Viper Gogi. This is Mecha. Then there's an hookshot in into Mitch. Yeah, that's a target that he can go for. He can charge out right now. Is he gonna be pushed over the cocks? No, he's not. She comes in there as well and he just picks up the kill.
You had your warning.
Yeah, G is. He's doing fine. Mitch, however, he is not too happy. Just level 5 on the Spirit Breaker there. And oh, gee, he goes in and he's able to still zip out while getting the rune here. Three people for my insanity are there to go at it. So.
Solo on the top lane, getting some me time. Well deserved. He's been running around, securing farm for his team. Yeah, well played by Solo so far.
Early level 6 on a Rubick is always nice, especially versus a 5.
Yeah, oh, and the bot lane, Maledict on Gogi.
They aren't actually able to catch him. He's gonna get 5 strike out onto Mech. Mech is now a little bit caught between 3 heroes right now. He's gonna get body blocked a little bit more. And he's still alive yet. Yeah, there you go. He will still die there to the Spirit Breaker Orb effect.
Ooh, and Solo in trouble.
Is he gonna run away there? No, Mitch. He's gonna go for Solo. The Maledict up, thrown back, charge in, going after Seema. Yeah, he knows that Solo is dead. He will leave him there. And Seema, tier 2. There we go. Another urn charge used to kill him off. Mitch, however, really low right now. Tower, not enough to kill him. Okay.
Yeah.
HP. Now he can just use an urn to heal up or just, you know, walk back to base. He decides to use the urn.
Yeah, some really aggressive wards from the Radiant is wow. Sorry, defensive wards from the Radiant. They're making sure to camp out that top lane, so making it sure it's really safe for any person going up there, probably for Lizard. And yeah, there's also a Radiant ward on the mid lane as well, just making sure that everything's all nice and safe. And a Midas on Viper. Hmm. What do you think about that?
Well, that is something that you see picked up from time to time on save lane Vipers, but yeah, it's just to get the bridge to late game. We always have farm, so you can always start building items, and even now with 12 minutes, it's still fine to get it. But yeah, you usually see it before maybe the mecha, but yeah, it's still a good pickup here. And will help him transition into the late game fairly effectively. Since he can't go into the jungle, since we have a Meepo staking there out. He just wants everything.
Yeah, Lizard's been really passive so far. He's just biding his time.
Yeah, he almost got an Aghanim, so that's why.
Yeah.
He just 1.3 cash. Gee, he's looking for this nice old Meepo here. And Meepo, yeah, he's gonna get pulled in. Not allowed to poof out, but he will still be able to make it because he just doesn't have the damage to keep him there. He's gonna get hit here right now. Stunned, there we go. He's able to get out, push back. Zip, no, Split Earth on the edge. Lightning is there, so he can still zip out. Is it far enough? No, it's not. Pulse Nova still hits him. And Meepo, he still dies though here on the bot lane due to the hookshot from Mech and the rotation of the two supports with him.
Yeah, G's been really shut out this game. Most of the focus of my insanity has been on G because G last game was very strong on that Shadow Fiend, and they've realized that G's a playmaker, they need to shut him out somehow. And they have.
Yeah, but at the same time, they're still leaving Pasha all alone. He has 0-0-0, but it's 125 less hits. Given that some of them are, of course, jungle creeps, but still 125 less hits at 30 minutes is a lot.
Definitely well above par.
Crazy.
Yeah, he's been playing outstandingly. Yeah, there we go.
But he needs to. You're just wondering when will he start getting into the fights? Will he just finish off his boots now? Maybe get DOTs because he's already going a farming oriented build. And after that, the Fusel Blade. But while saying it, they're actually going to go into bot here, and Seema is going to take a fall. He tries to TP out. Just a little bit too much damage, and Seema, the Slayer, also dies here to the Dazzle.
Ooh. I think Vega believes Solo that they have a better late game, charge. So they're just going to. Oh, sorry.
Better result. Yeah, he's gonna get cocked in here. Gogi, yeah, he's not able to get anything off here. GRF, he's zipping around a lot. He's still really low. The urn is still digging him down. Split Earth hits onto Mech. Mech pulls Nova, doing a lot of damage. There we go, kills him off. TP out from Solo is gonna be in time. Yes, it is. And G also still survives.
Only just.
That's true. But yeah, you were saying.
I forgot, I've lost apps. Oh, yeah, there we go.
Yeah, you were talking about the late game potential late game of my Sentia.
Yeah. Vega have late game, they've realized, leave Pasha alone in the jungle, let's just make space for him, and Pasha's just looking to take that cheeky tower sometimes. I really think that Pasha can obviously take this late game, like, he's got this under control.
I don't think that, it's actually quite, maybe, yeah, Stormshift is still a good hero there as well. Oh, one of the Meepo died on top. But yeah, just go to say, like, if Meepo can get a good start, he can just easily go into a high core position there. Because essentially right now they're playing four cores with one support. With Meepo being, you know, higher net worth than Spirit Breaker. There we go, they're gonna go up to solo, but he just gets lifted up into the air, thrown back. So the half HP Weave is used offensively, or defensively here. Solo, yeah. That Yule's into Split Earth, kill them up there.
Yeah, just punch him in the face with Spirit Breaker.
Yeah, we're actually seeing Spirit the Yule's build right now of Milan and not the bit more standard Bloodstone build.
Maybe he might get a drum with that bracer he has. Oh, I'm not too sure.
Yeah, I think it's just a casual one.
Casual one? The casual bracer. Casual.
You have to get something on your arms, you know, you have to look pretty.
Yeah, the rainbow pony doesn't look pretty enough without the braces.
Oh, you need it. You also need a necklace, but maybe we'll see if he picks up a casual one of those as well. Highly doubt it though.
Nah, probably not, no.
Ooh. Dizzard, he is low. He might actually take the fall here. There we go. G-Zips in, kills him off.
Yeah, he's quite close to that action center. Oh my god, Mitch is going deep right now.
Yeah, he goes in. He finds Seema, but he has to run away right now because he's actually taking low. While G on the back line is trying to fight up versus Milan. But Milan's a little bit too strong. Pulse Nova. He shuts it off. No more mana. Lightning Storm. Lightning used. Seema charged onto him. Underneath the tier 2 tower. He's going to hit him. Charged back onto him as well from solo. Shadowgrave just on time here. He still keeps on fighting. He needs to get this cask off of him, but it doesn't work. He will die here. Mac, he uses his battery assault, walks in after Gogi. Creeps are there taking quite a lot of it. Gogi is just trying to man fight here, but it just doesn't work. He has to start running away, but he won't make it.
Yeah. Both parties showing up late then. It was a 2-on-2, then it became a 5-on-5 all of a sudden. I think that Vega get the better of that exchange.
Yeah, it's a 3-for-1 essentially. Recap.
2,000 gold swing for the side of the Dire.
Yeah, that's shown now in the graphs.
Oh, Meepo died at the start as well. Yes, yeah. It's a 3-for-1.
Yep.
Well played indeed.
So now, my Sentinel maybe try to... Yeah, they need to start recovering, but they farm just faster.
Yeah.
Just with the Meepo there as a support, that you can just farm the jungle as well with two Meepos while having one other Meepo just run around the map all the time.
Pasha right now is an absolute sponge. He's soaking up every bit of farm all over the map.
And Mac in the mid lane here, he just gets blown up by the three-man rotation here.
Hmm. Mana Boots Viper, hey?
It's just to get the mech off, and he's just going to build it into Greaves.
Yeah, I think Greaves would be the best bet.
Charge into Pasha. Is he going to doppelganger out of this? And there we go. Perfectly on time. And he's now starting his build towards the lightning. He's built towards the Diffuser Blade. We'll have a little bit of a fight here. Yule Scepter is going to be used. Yeah, there we go. And Split Earth. Oh, it's off the mark. Illusions are popped here. And the cask is bouncing around him quite nicely. Well, G is trying to fight here from the back line. He has to zip out again. Well, Mitch takes a follow here towards the Death Ward and Pasha. Now Lizard comes in with all the Meepos, but he isn't canceling the Death Ward. And one of his Meepos is actually fairly low. They're still on the front line. Meepo is still alive. Now they're going to go Milan. Lashfrak, he's trying to fight up versus Mac here, but Mac is winning this fight with the help of Solo. Solo charges in into the back, he finds Lizard. Milan is still running around, there's gonna be the lens to kill him off. They're gonna go after Pasha now, doppelganger out. Gogi is still going after him, but he can't find the real one. He finally saw the real one, but it's underneath the tier 1 tower already. Oh, Pasha, he's still on the run. He just juked him all the way around. There's gonna be the doppelganger again. He knows who's the real one, but he's not able to pursue this because there's still Mac going after him. And the rest of Vegas are now also backing him up. We're all near the tier 1 tower and Gogi is all alone. There's going to be the charge, but it's still coming all the way from the base. And it won't be nearly on time.
Did you see what Pasha did then? He kited perfectly.
Around the trees, using his quelling blade.
Yeah. That's just great. Oh, Mag. Mag's dead. Yeah, fortunate for Mag there.
And they're TPing in two people here. But will MySenti try to fight this Grazine? He uses Shadow Grave onto himself. G is already... Yeah, they're gonna just leave Grazine here.
Sacrificial lamb, poor guy.
Someone has to be.
Yeah, the Shadow Graves have been on point so far, in my opinion. Like, he's been playing very well.
And oh yeah, the Shadow Grave there, it's really... it just buys time. He knew he was dead. Lizard. So, Meepo acronyms. 20 minute support, but yeah.
What are you thinking for Roshan on both teams? What are you thinking?
Well, quite obviously, Mindsanity have the edge.
Yeah, around the Rosh pit, I would believe Mindsanity have
the edge. Killing Rosh, they have the edge in the round. Yeah. They don't really have. Neither of these teams have like these big teamfight ultimates. The only real thing is. Yeah, Lesrak running around and a Death Ward.
Yes.
It's not those big Enigma Black Holes, Magnus RPs or whatever, but. Yeah. There's actually. Both teams are quite reliant on pickoffs.
The net worth looks pretty even right now. Just having a look, it's just gone past the zero mark towards the Dire side.
Yeah, Vega taking a lot back right now.
Looking at the hero levels, man. Pasha's well ahead, level 15. Two levels above anyone else.
Yeah, after that is the Meepo, but yeah, it's a Meepo.
We should take a moment to look at the Dire Courier. Very sexy indeed.
A gold dragon. I like it.
I love the particle effects. They're amazing. And a top tower going to Milan. More gold going the way of my insanity.
Yeah, well, they're trying to look for a mid tower here, but I reckon my insanity is going to come back and defend this. Well, they're actually just going to take a kill on solo first, and no, they're not going to defend it. Just going to let the tower fall. And they take the Rupee kill for granted. Tower is under attack. Ding dong. I'm just wondering, was the Aghanim's a good item for Meepo first? Because I would think with the Blink Dagger, he was able to maybe move around a little bit more in the beginning and just get a little bit more done. But with the Aghanim's, he of course can farm it back really fast. So.
The more the merrier, I think. He just has more bros in the party.
With more bros, he can do more damage.
Yeah, exactly. And no doubt that his Meepo is very good indeed. I think Aghanim's might be the way forward.
Yeah, if you got the micro skills to do it, then. So I just like the blink. Just fun.
Yeah,
the
blink's always
start
fun.
Poofing. Mm. Especially with the Rubik and the Witch Doctor, which just easily die to you.
Yeah. Oh, he's got the Blink Dagger.
And now I got it.
Come on, Lizard. Show us what you're made of. Let's have some sick micro skills. Come on.
He's getting all of his Meepos out and just leaves the main one. But that means that all of the poofs are on cooldown right now. There you go. There's only one. So he has to wait for the others right now. Spit Herb does hit him. There you go. There's going to be a net strike as well. Solo has to start running away. But he's just going to pursue him. Lightning slows him down. And there you go. Another blink forward. Solo is dead as well. Double kill going the way of Milan.
That's a very late Bloodstone on G. But maybe he can catch up with a few extra Bloodstone charges. We don't know.
This is not the best Orchid game. Like, it doesn't really matter versus a Viper, Meepo. Congratulations, you still have three other Meepos bouncing on your head. It's good versus a
very true indeed.
Milan as well, but Milan, he essentially is going to get a BKB soon.
Yeah.
And you're not looking to fight right now anyway.
Nah, definitely take it late, especially for... I keep saying especially, sorry. Vega want to take it late.
And then... You're not going to go for an Orchid, it just takes up a slot, especially in late game when everybody already has BKB, so you're just already looking for that with this late Bloodstone.
Yeah, Mindsanity, their draft kicks in around about the 20 to 35 minute mark, roughly.
20-30,
they're dominating now.
Like, there's no way to really stop them. Apart from maybe overextension on the side of Mindsanity.
Man of Chalk sniped a faceless Rex Courier today. Congratulations. Everyone's looking for that. Well played.
Oh, congratulations on that. Don't forget to gift it to me after the cast.
Yeah, you can always gift it to me as well. Just add me on Steam.
Oh, and they're going to go in here on middle. Spit Earth hits him to Meg. Meg is forcing himself out, but it doesn't really matter. There's going to be the Death Ward, but it's going to get cancelled straight away with all of these nets here. Mitch is really low, and there you go. Zip over kills him off. Oh, actually, Ruby kills him there. And he's out there. It's a 1-for-2 trade. And they're just going to start walking back a little bit more and maybe just go at it again. And yeah, going to leave Pasha alone here. All the Meepos are back together. Lifting to the air. G found. He dies as well. Solo now. No, Nets are off the mark. Where's the real Meepo? carry.
Yeah, Pasha's a... You know how I was talking about how Pasha is two levels above anyone else? Now look at Meepo now. Level 18.
But that's just what the Meepo does.
Yeah, it takes all experience off the map. Thank you very much indeed.
Yeah, that's usually why you see the supports fairly underleveled. And other heroes that want to take a part in the jungle are not able to do so.
Hmm. So I feel very... Yeah, little ancient black dragon all alone. Poor guy. Yeah. In the dire camp.
You usually see like they leave the smallest one. Just because the black dragon is most gold. Yeah, it doesn't really matter.
Oh, solo. Solo's getting charged on. Oh! This is coming in.
That hurt. Back is there as well. Oh yeah, they're all more than enough back up here. Solo is just gonna take a spill here. Four stuff forward, he's fine. He's going in fairly deep. Look at this, he's already at tier 2 and just draw a line out here like past this and no further, and he's still there.
Yeah. I've seen worse drawn on the map. I've seen worse.
At least they're forcing Mind Sentry back to defend both lanes. Milan is not gonna find him, and they just take an easy rush here with all of the Meepos.
Yeah, Lizard picks it up. Reckon that's the wisest choice?
That's just nice to do it. He's actually gonna go for this is gonna be a Skadi. Yeah, this is usually Skadi that you build up here.
Yeah, Skadi Meepo, best Meepo. Ooh. On the top lane, Seam has been caught out.
Dima. Yeah, this is gonna be a dead Witch Doctor here. But he tries to turn it around and he's just gonna deny. Okay.
Yeah. He couldn't do it anymore, he had to go.
He just didn't want to give a kill to Pasha there, so. Sacrificing yourself for that is just fine. And they straight up smoke here. Mitch is a little bit low on mana though, so do they have arcanes? I believe they had them. On Gogi, they already get grease.
Man of Chalk, he said, I meant snipe literally as in a Janada crit. He sniped a courier, well played, Man of Chalk. He didn't actually get one, he lied to us.
Boo!
Boo, Man of Chalk.
Boo.
Why?
Don't play Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, don't play Bounty. No one likes Bounty Hunter.
Oh,
Solo.
Solo's
been in charge.
Yeah, he just picked up the gem as well, and he's gonna lose it straight away. That's actually... this is really terrible.
Haven't seen it.
What? They should have seen this. There should be somebody going there to pick it up. What?
No.
Go.
And the courier's going on a mission right now.
So, okay, well.
See it.
They just gave it back. Okay, that's quite odd.
Yeah.
And Meepo is losing his first life here. Pasha is still there, doppelgangering out, and I don't think the Meepos are able to find him right now. Net. Oh, they are in range, but this one doesn't hit. They need more Meepos.
G's in deep, and he's TPing out. He knows that he can't do anything. Oh, man.
However, Mech.
So dead.
Those poofers.
Yeah, he just poofed all over him.
Yeah, Pasha, you just run into Mitch and Gogi. That's not. That's two people that you don't want to run in, and they're just gonna transition this into probably a tier 3 pusher on their bot if they had creeps, that is. Which they don't, so they have to go to middle.
My Insanity have realized, yo, we need to finish this game sooner rather than later. Pasha is looking very fat indeed. With that Manta style, Diffusal Blade, Massive Madness, Boost of Travel, he is stacked right now. So they're just like, we gotta finish it now, boys. And that's they are.
He has about 14k net worth still. I do say that Meepo really does well versus the BL. So.
Yeah, just net. Smacking on the front doors right now.
Another net. That one's going to be off the mark. I guess bounces through. A lot of nets thrown. And they just take an easy set of Rex here. Oh no, they're actually going to leave this one behind. G. He goes in, goes back out, and they're going to go for another 2-3. They just don't want to wait till Pasha gets back, and they want to get a little bit more structural damage in here.
Yeah, they're just smacking it down, they don't care. My Insanity don't care, look, they've gone in the melee right
now. G goes over them. Hookshot in as well, but he's just fighting up versus all these Meepo, and that's not really what you want to do. Zima, he's going to get netted here, so they cancel off the ultimate there, and run in as well. Mitch, well, G pulls back one of the Meepos. Meepo is really low. Ooh, Shadow Grave onto him, he's still fine. He's going to use the other Meepos to continue fighting him. Well, they find G. G's taking a lot of damage. He's getting slowed a bit, but still fine. Buyback use on Zima. Look at all these Meepos. Range Rex almost down, they just kill off. Solo here, G is into the air, he has about 500 mana, he's able to zip out just fine. Will they be able to pick up the gem right now? Yes.
Where is it?
Mish has it. Shadowblade starts running away. Lizard, he wants to get out, but no. Meepo is dead. No. Doesn't work. Doesn't work away. Zip in. Milan is found. Regine is found. They both will die here. But they got two lanes of Rex. So I don't think they have anything to complain about.
Yeah, this is...
Oh, as well as actually Meepo was sniped by the rocket.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to say it. I think it's GG.
Yeah, I don't
think... They can't hold out against the Mega Creeps. Not at the moment.
Also, they have such a big net worth and momentum boost right now for Mindset.
Yeah.
Over 15k net worth and just over 10k XP.
Yeah, the deficit is very bad.
And now they even have a sight already on the Viper. This is a utility Viper if I've ever seen one.
Oh yeah, the Cypher Vice, that's a lovely pickup indeed. I thought
They're gonna build a second sight on Meepo as well. I was really wondering if it's gonna be a sight or the Scali, but it's gonna be another sight as well. They just have infinite lockdown then. It's gonna be crazy.
Yeah.
And would already
I've just realized. Meepo's got a sheep stick too.
Yeah, I just said so.
Yeah, I know, sorry. I'm deaf sometimes.
That's fine.
Yeah, Meepo's been dead for 90 seconds near enough. Like, this is a horrible time for Meepo. He's just so far ahead that he's dead forever.
Yeah, that's the kind of problem. And with not having the 20 seconds respawn reduction is actually really tough for him. Now, they might actually have a team fight here. They have a little bit of a stare off, and there you go. Gogi just runs in and they see him, he sees them. Hookshots. Mitch goes in first, he wants to look a little bit what's going on here exactly. He sees all of them. And Milan, he runs in, pulls Nova on, BKB on, and the whole side of Vega just has to start running back, but that doesn't work versus Mitch. He just uses his nether strike to get one back in again. On the back line, G also dies here. Towards the Meepo, and on the tier 2 they keep on going, solo? Low Seema, he gets off a death ward. Mitch is stuck in it, but there is gonna be Lizard. Reinforcements have arrived in the form of a lot of Meepos. The rest of them now follows up, 4 people dead. This is GG, no buybacks. Only person still alive is Solo, running to his base to defend the tier 4s. Now he has Pulse Nova. Oh, yeah.
And sorry Twitch chat, Moobot is taken. You cannot date Moobot. Moobot is mine. Don't ask Moobot out on a date, thank you very much.
Please ask her out on a date. They give her dinner and stuff, then we don't have to do that. She will still come home.
Yeah.
there you go. There you go, they call it. Oh my god, Milan! Don't be a dick. I'm just referring to the fact that he accidentally sent GG in the beginning. After 1 minute. And now he's like already.
Well, thank you very much, but I have to go now.
Yeah, and it was good to have you here. And just to say, it was game 2 of this best of 3. Mayan Sandy took this one with the Meepo picks showing really strong and with the early game lineup just taking it all away. Zach was with me casting. You can follow him at Zach_Owen. Just give him some love there. And I'm going to go into the commercials. And you guys for the third match in this best of 3 in the lower bracket. Semi-final.
Yeah, thank you, everybody.
Yeah, go. Shoot. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.